Good morning to everyone, and once again welcome to Geography class. In this class we are going to talk and discuss about something very special. So let's proceed to see what is very special. Yes, by seeing this image, what comes to your mind? Yes, you are right, we are talking about sun, cloud, then rainfall, then thunder, lightning and all. So, it's clear to you, we are going to discuss about the fourth topic of the geography, that is the climate and weather. So, moving further to start our chapter number 4. So, chapter number 4, climate, in that topic number 1, we are going to have a discussion on the introduction of the chapter and climate and weather. Right? So I request you, this chapter is very important. Please thoroughly see each and every point which is very important for you. Point number 1, the introduction of the chapter speaking, today's weather condition is different. Yesterday's weather condition was different. Oh, today's atmosphere is totally changing. So like that we used to have to comment on each and every day about the weather condition, right? So weather is an R2R changing condition of the atmosphere, and climate is the average one of the weather, right? So moving further to discuss about what is climate and what is weather, we are going to see in a broad way in this chapter. The name of the chapter is climate. First, the last two chapter you have read about the landforms and the drainage of our country. These are the two of the three basic elements that one learn about the natural environment of any area. The chapter number 1 was speaking about India's size and location, so we are not taking that. But the second chapter was talking about physical features of India. And the third chapter was talking about drainage, the Indian's river, northern and southern rivers. So next, in this chapter, you will learn about the third, that is the atmospheric condition. Have a look to this, atmospheric condition, that prevail over around country. Why do we wear woolen in December? So why do we wear woolen in December, or why it is hot and uncomfortable in the month of May, and why it's rain in June and July? So for a common example, you are in 9th standard, you are knowing about, I am talking here about the season, right? Winter season, summer season and rainy season. The next answer to all these questions can be found out by studying about the climate of India. The climate of India is creating all the things. Next, climates refer to the sum of the total. Please have attention here. This is the definition of climate. Climates refers to the sum total of weather condition and variation over a large area for a longer period of the time, and that period is more than 30 years. That's the definition of climate. Next, moving further, weather. Weather is equal to the state of atmosphere over an area at any point of time. It can be hour to hour, day to day, like that. The element of weather and climate are the same. Temperature, atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity and precipitation. We are going to see all this point in the upcoming presentation in a detailed way. These are the some points which are related to the both weather as well and the climate. Next, you may have observed that the weather condition fluctuates very often, even within a day, but there are some common patterns over a few weeks or a month. That day are cool and hot, windy and cloudy or bright, wet or dry. So it means about that, suppose morning it's raining, but afternoon afternoon it's sunny, and again in night it's becoming very cold. So the atmospheric condition is changing. That's a weather. It's an R to R change in the atmospheric condition. Moving further, on the basis of the generalization monthly atmospheric condition, the year is divided into seasons such as winter, summer, and rainy, as we were speaking in the earlier slides. So the world is divided into the number of climatic regions. Do you know what type of climate India has and why it is so? We will learn about it in this chapter. So in this chapter we are going to see about, so India's climate is monsoon climate, monsoon type climate it is here. Moving further to understand about, do you know the word monsoon is derived from the Arabic word mosin, which means season. Monsoon refers to the seasonal reversals in the wind direction during a year. So monsoon winds are bringing rainfall in India. Okay, so this do you know is very important. From this any MCQ can appear, or one sentence question answers will come. So we are having the discussion on the weather and climate. Now we are seeing the season and moving further. Please copy down this do you know in your notebook, that the do you know is speaking. The word origin of monsoon. Then the climate of India described as the monsoon type. As I stated you, the question was there, what type of climate India is having? So monsoon type. In Asia, this type of climate is found mainly in the south and southeast. Despite an overall unity in the general pattern, there are the perceptible regional variation in the climatic condition within the country. Let us take the two important elements, temperature and precipitation. Temperature, precipitation, that means we are going to be talking about rainfall, right? And examine how they are varied from place to place and season to season. We are going to see how the temperature in Jammu and Kashmir it is cold, in Rajasthan it is too hot. Like that, we are going to compare. In Rajasthan there is very less rainfall, in Mausim Ran there is a huge rainfall, and making the place as a world wettest place in the world. In summer, the mercury occasionally touches the 50 degrees in the some part of Rajasthan desert, where it may be around 20 degrees in Falun and in Jammu and Kashmir. Then, on the winter night, the temperature at Dras in Jammu and Kashmir may be as low as minus 45 degrees. The Trivandrumpuram, on the other hand, may have a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. So by seeing, you are all already knowing about the climatic condition of India, which places are hot, which places are cold. Generally, at the summer vacation, you used to move to the hill station. At the summer also, you want that particular place. So it should be just like Ooty, Kullu, Manali, so many places, hill stations are there. People are moving for their enjoyment in summer season. So, moving further, let us now look at the precipitation. There are the variations not only in the form and the type of precipitation, but also in its amount and the seasonal distribution. It speaks about this, somewhere is it more rainfall, somewhere very less rainfall, and somewhere it is no fall, like that. And the distribution is also different. Somewhere in winter it's raining, in summer season it's sometimes it's raining. So while precipitation is the most in the form of snowfall, in the upper part of the Himalaya, it rains over all the rest of the country. Moving further, the annual precipitation varies from over 4000 cm in Meghalaya. which I was talking about, Cherrapunji, Mausam Gram, right? Next, to less than 10 cm in Ladakh and the western Rajasthan, we are talking about the desert area or arid area. The most part of the country receives the rainfall in the month of June to September. But some part of the India, we are having just like Tamil Nadu state, they are getting the rainfall in the month of October and November. These points we are going to have discussion more on this topic. Why Chennai receives more rainfall in winter season rather than in the rainy season? Like that question we are going to discuss. Next, after seeing this, you are understanding about how the temperature and precipitation is different or varies from place to place. That's why the climate of that particular area is changed. In general, the coastal area experience less contrast in the temperature condition, that means a moderate one. Seasonal contrasts are more in the interior of the country. There is decrease in the rainfall generally from the east to west in the northern plains. The variation has given rise to the variety in the lives of people in terms of food they eat and the clothes they wear and also the kind of house they live in. So by the temperature, by the precipitation, whole areas climate is going to be different. And if the climate is going to be changed, so the people's food habit, dressing pattern and living things is going to be totally changed. So like that, the climate is very important part of our day-to-day life. So next, here again, thank you to Manan for watching the videos. Be safe and secure at your home and Jai Hind. Lastly, I want to speak to you all, whatever the point I am speaking to you, please write in your notebook and have a continuity of this chat. I am so happy so many students are having different doubts and sending to me and they are getting their doubt to be shot out. I request you all, please observe all the videos and get benefited. Thank you once again.